A lot of you are very curious about how you can use Excel workbooks in Microsoft Copilot, so I have done the experimenting for you, and I've got two successes and one fairly epic fail to share with you here. So to start with, I've already uploaded my documents in here. Check out my introductory video if you would like to follow along and get started here. What I've got is a spreadsheet that is a list of warehouse items in stock. I've got a fictional widget company here. I've got all of these things. You'll see this one is actually quite a long spreadsheet. I've got 2,000 rows in here, but each widget only exists in one warehouse location. That's going to be important. Spoiler alert. The second spreadsheet I've got here is much shorter, but this is a little bit more complex. This is a sales pipeline. You can see, as with any sales pipeline, you've got people who are looking after multiple opportunities. So it's not just like a single line per fact as we had in the previous one. And for good measure, here are the amazing features and benefits of all of my widget products. I've just got the first four in there. And we're going to have a little bit of a play with the interaction between this Word document and the Excel spreadsheet. That's the most fun we're going to have. Make sure you stay watching until we get to that part. So what I'm going to do here is ask it some questions. Let's start with one of the successes. Let's let it succeed first. So what I'm going to do here is grab, I've got my questions here so you don't need to watch me type. We're going to ask it, how many of widget mini do we have in stock and in which warehouse? Now, while it's figuring that out, let's go and find the answer here. Widget mini is in warehouse C and we have 352 in stock. Let's go back in here. We currently have 352 widget mini in stock in warehouse C. Yay, well done. Well done, widget sales helper Copilot. Let's step it up a notch and see if it can handle a little bit more of a complex question here. How many of Widget Pro 0026 do we have in stock and on order, and what date is it due? 307, oh, here we go. We've got 42 in stock, 307 on order, and the due date is 12/12/23. Let's check its answer there. 42, 307, again, a success. What this Copilot capability, generative AI capability, is doing is indexing the content of your documents and then finding the relevant content in there. So it works very well with unstructured text like Word documents, less well with structured text, as we're about to see. But it is able to extract information. So it's looking for, and it's indexed all this information. I think why this spreadsheet is working quite well is because each widget only has one row in the spreadsheet. So I'm searching for that and finding it. It does less well with the sales pipeline. The other thing it's not able to do is calculations. Let's set it up to fail a little bit here. So if you're looking for something that's going to do calculations on your spreadsheet, this, I'm afraid, is not going to be the tool. Let's check this out. Which product has the highest quantity in stock? Unfortunately, it won't just kind of come back with a, I can't do that. It's going to give you an answer that's wrong. The product with the highest quantity in stock is Widget Lite with 770. Let's come in here and have a look. 770, and see, we can see straight away there are others in there with 900, 900, 800. It's not even close to the correct answer. So if you are using this, you've got to think of this as that it's indexing the content in your document and it's designed to search for relevant content. So if you've got a spreadsheet where that's the use case, index and search for relevant content, you're in the good zone. If you're asking it to do calculations, not going to do that. There are other tools in the stack that will help you with that. One of them is the Copilot for Excel. That's part of the bigger Microsoft 365 Copilot. Also, if you're using Dataverse, there are some options, but let me show you what happens with the sales pipeline and we'll come back to that one. So as we saw with this one, we've got, Jamie Smith, Peyton Davis. These are people who have multiple opportunities sitting in the pipeline. So let's come in here and I am going to grab something here that it can do. So again, if we're asking for a very specific piece of information, remember, it can search for relevant content. So what is the value of this opportunity? That's 3086. Let's take a look here. Opportunity 141, 3086. And in fact, it's able to figure out, my column is called total price and I asked it for the value and it was able to make that connection. So, you know, not bad. Specific information, it can find it. Again, if we ask it for a calculation of any kind, something like what is the highest value opportunity, how many opportunities are in the develop stage, it just can't. that's not going to be the right tool for that. The other one to be wary of here is something like this, where it looks like it's doing the right thing, but it's not really. Please list all of the opportunities where Jamie Smith is the salesperson. I've played around a bit with this and I'm getting a 50-50 accurate to hallucination rate. So we have now got Jamie Smith, opportunity 152, 153 and 154. Let's take a look. Jamie Smith, 152, 153, 154 is Morgan Garcia, not even close. So it feels like it's giving you the right information there. It's actually really not doing the right job. Check out my other video here on model-driven apps Copilot. That is a tool to handle this kind of structured data. So if you're working with something like this, Excel is just not going to be the right data source and this is not going to be the right tool. But let me show you something very cool here that you can do with this. It is much better at summarizing what's going on and extracting that content. So you'll remember I had my document in here where I listed out the pros and cons, the features and benefits of my widget things. So let's ask it to compose something, and it actually does not a bad job of this. So what I'm going to do is we will pop in here an instruction to say our customer Prime Services is interested in the widget Max. Please write an email to them listing the features and letting them know how many we have in stock and when the next order is due. So you start to extrapolate the use case a little bit here. Rather than thinking about use cases here for Copilot Studio where you want to upload Excel and pretend it's structured data and find it, that's your fail. But this less structured data, find the information, search, generate something out of it, you can actually do quite well. So here we go. We've got, I hope this email finds you well. We've got a nice summary of the features. So let's just check it. Widget Max has an expansive 12-inch display. So let's have a look at our thing here. Widget Max expansive 12-inch. So it's bringing all of that content in here, writing it as an email. We've got this, please note it's subject to change. This is pretty good, new order due date. Now, if you've used something like ChatGPT, you'll be familiar with this kind of thing. Please rewrite this email and make it shorter. This doesn't seem to be able to handle that. So we're not working with something that's doing that kind of thing. Remember, back to these principles of it's going through and indexing your documents. The bigger picture here with Copilot Studio is that you might have other conversational topics that are highly structured that do things. This is designed to be a fallback topic, so I'm now pushing it a little bit out of its intended use case here. But if you make your prompt more specific from the start, you can get a really good outcome with this. So I want you to think about using Excel here in a way that is searching and finding the data. And if you want to work with something that's more structured, get yourself out of Excel and into Power Apps. Check out my video here on how you can do that.